إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار Salamat ibn Kuhail, he said, this month is the month of readers. Amr ibn Qais, whenever the month of Sha'ban came in, he would close his shop and opens the Quran and starts to read the Quran. Abu Bakr al-Balkhi said, Rajab is the month of sowing the seeds. Sha'ban is the month of watering the plant. Ramadan is the month of harvest. And he said also, the month of Rajab is like the wind. The month of Sha'ban is like the clouds. The month of Ramadan is like the rain. Whosoever did not sow the seeds in Rajab and water the plant in Sha'ban, therefore, how could he be a winner in the month of Ramadan? This is a prime case of our ancestors, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions, their thought and knowledge of the month of Sha'ban as they venture into the month of Ramadan. An Usam ibn Zayd radiyallahu anhuma qal, he said to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, I've never seen you fast more days in a month, of course, other than Ramadan, than the month of Sha'ban. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, this is a month where a lot of people ignore and they are not aware of it. It is between Rajab and Ramadan. It is the month, and watch out for this sentence, it is the month where our deeds are raised to Allah Almighty. And I want, when my deeds, a'mal, are raised to Allah Almighty, they are raised while I am fasting. The companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, 6 months prior to Ramadan, they would ask Allah Almighty to accept, to give them the lifetime to be alive in the month of Ramadan. And then 6 months after Ramadan, they ask Allah Almighty to accept their deeds in the month of Ramadan. That is why they've always said, oh Allah, grant me Ramadan and give Ramadan to me. Give me the opportunity of Ramadan and accept Ramadan from me. Imam ibn Rajab al-Hanbali says a marvelous statement to explain the full attention and the change of mood in Muslim communities at that time towards the month of Ramadan. He said, fasting in the month of Sha'ban, it's just like training for the month of Ramadan. Because if you fast the few days or couple of days or more days of Sha'ban, as you venture into the month of Ramadan, it will be less difficult and stressful, and you are able to adjust in the month of Ramadan immediately. And therefore, you are trained to fast in the month of Ramadan. Also, he said, you would sample the pleasure of fasting in the month of Ramadan, in the month of Sha'ban, in order to enjoy the pleasure of fasting in the month of Ramadan with full force and power and activity and motivation. There is some good news, my dear brothers and sisters. Extreme temperatures. In this country, and especially this part of the world, Ramadan is during the hot weather season. Let me remind you of something. Mu'adh ibn Jabal, when he was dying, he said on his deathbed, he said, I miss the days I used to fast when the weather was extremely hot. The son of Umar ibn al-Khattab, as he was dying, he said, two things that I am going to miss when I die: my fasting during hot days and my walking to the masjid. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu used to fast more days in the summer than the days in winter. Umar ibn al-Khattab, as he was dying, he said to his son Abdullah, he said, fast days that are extremely hot. Aisha radiallahu anha, she used to fast the hot days. And one of the Muslim righteous worshippers at their time, she was asked, why do you fast during the hot days? And she said it in an example. She said, cheap merchandise, everyone can afford. Expensive merchandise, only few people can afford. In other words, the more it is difficult, the more the reward is. The month of Sha'ban is the month where our annual deeds are raised to Allah Almighty. In a better statement, to clarify this, it is our annual report is raised to Allah Almighty. And to the boys here who are in school, it is your final grade that goes to Allah Almighty. So in order to boost your grade when it is raised to Allah Almighty about your 11 months performance, when you fast and your grades are raised to Allah Almighty, your fasting is a bonus towards your grade and a bonus to your performance. And perhaps some of us have failed, and all of us must have failed one way or another. So Sha'ban and the fasting of the month of Sha'ban gives us the ability to mend and fix that failure and weakness in our performance. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. The first part of the khutbah was the theoretical part for you and me to understand. The following points are the practical application in all what is said, in points for you and me to look over in the next few days, or starting this day onwards till we reach the month of Ramadan inshallah. First of all, adjustment. Check yourself, how many times do you go to the masjid during the day for prayers of jama'ah? From now on, you start adjusting things in order to make sure that all of your prayers are in the masjid, in jama'ah, and on time. The second thing is, you monitor and review your 11 months performance and your relationship with Allah throughout this year. And remember whatever mistakes and failures that you have done, and ask Allah Almighty to forgive you for these things, and feel guilty for your mishaps and failures that took over the 11 months, because now your report is raised to Allah Almighty. So when you show Allah Almighty that you feel guilty and ask Allah for your forgiveness, Allah will grant you forgiveness as your grade goes to Allah Almighty. Second point, intention. It is extremely important that you know what you're doing and for whom you are doing this for. You are doing it for the sake of Allah. You are doing it because you are venturing to the month of Ramadan. You are doing this because you want to perform in the month of Ramadan better than the other Ramadan before. So from now, your intention has to adjust. The adjustments of the intention is not by the words of intention. It is by your behavior. And that comes from the following. First of all, you start reading about do's and don'ts in the month of Ramadan. You start listening to lectures and seminars about how to perform in the month of Ramadan. You start listening as you are driving here from one place to another to various lectures and issues, and read about what it takes for you to take and to perform in the month of Ramadan. All such information, you show Allah Almighty that you are serious about yourself and in your relationship with Allah, and how serious you are as you want to go through the month of Ramadan, and how serious you are as your deeds throughout the year are raised to Allah Almighty. Third point, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that in the middle of the month of Sha'ban, Allah looks in the hearts in the Muslims and the believers, and he would forgive them, except the ones who have a certain dispute with others. So if you have any issue with anybody, try to fix your relationship with him in order your heart is clear and therefore your deeds are raised to Allah Almighty. Now point number four. Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. O Allah Almighty, give me the opportunity to be alive in the month of Ramadan. This is what the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say it year long, even this during this month. There is a difference between a person when he prays, he asks Allah, grant me the opportunity to live through the month of Ramadan, rather than the person who looks into the calendar, today is Ramadan, I am fasting. It's a huge difference in your behavior, in your emotions, in your relationship with Allah Almighty. All what it takes, that you take it seriously, as you perform, as you do the dua, as you sujood, and in your prayers, ask Allah Almighty that you are granted the pleasure of the month of Ramadan. And Allahu A'lam, anyone who does not make it through the month of Ramadan, or he dies before that, at least in his intention, there was a will to be granted Ramadan, and Allah would reward him for it. Point number six, Quran. If you are a person who reads Quran on a daily basis, you start escalating the amount of Quran that you read. And if you're a person who did not open the Quran, you start opening the Quran and read it on a gradual escalation. So it increases gradually towards the end of the month of Sha'ban. Therefore, you have a change in your behavior and in your ability, and also an increase in your level of performance. So your entry level of Ramadan will be stronger than any person who only opens the book of Allah in the month of Ramadan. Another point, dua. Start gathering information and teach yourself the teachings of the Prophet ﷺ in the dua. Whereas the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the basic principles of du'a, he told us about adhkar al-sabah and adhkar al-masa, the morning supplications and the evening supplications. If you are someone like me, I'll tell you about myself. I did not memorize them and I don't know how to memorize them. I used to put them in a tape while driving to work in the morning and while driving back in the evening. And after so many months, I started reading as it is. And nowadays it's on the YouTube, morning supplications, evening supplications of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So as the supplications are said, you read it with it and you memorize it. And various supplications that the Prophet Muhammad told us about. Point number five or six. The time you spend in the masjid. Usually we come to the masjid, pray the sunnahs, pray the fard, and then if there are sunnahs afterwards, we leave. Stay a little bit longer, not that much, little bit longer in an escalation towards the end of the month of Sha'ban. This way, you condition yourself that in the month of Ramadan, you would accept i'tikaf. And therefore, you start enjoying the pleasure of being in the masjid and remembering Allah Almighty. That takes place from this month onwards. As I said before, fasting also. Try to fast the days possible for you in Sha'ban in order your strength is different than a person who starts fasting the first day of Ramadan. Charity. Discipline yourself from this day onwards to have a small box in your home and to put a certain amount of money. The amount is not important, more than the action is important. is that you teach yourself every day you start, you put a certain amount of money in that box and then you donate the amount in it. Why? Because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, that every morning two angels come and they say, oh Allah, give a person who spends money the longevity and the blessings, and give a person who holds his money the depression and the waste. Waking up before Fajr. In the few weekends that are coming before the month of Ramadan, if you don't go to work or have a school, try one of them to wake up before Fajr prayer and pray tahajjud, two rak'ahs or four, in what of a preparation for the month of Ramadan, where you wake up before Fajr for suhoor and then you start praying these two rak'ahs, to put it in your discipline and adjust yourself, especially since our deeds are raised to Allah Almighty. The final point, Umrah. If you are someone who will not go to Umrah in Ramadan, listen to the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, whoever prays subh, fajr in jama'ah, in a masjid, and he stays in the masjid till the sunrise, and he prays two rak'ahs, he is rewarded like hajj and umrah, complete, complete, complete. These are a few principles I wanted to share with you. And as I shared them with you, it's my duty and your duty to share it with others who are not among us. Your family, your office mates, your classmates, anyone you meet, try to propagate this message. And also increase the motivations of Muslims towards Ramadan, not the first day of Ramadan, from now the month of Sha'ban, as I gave you the previous examples, where the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Muslims, the month of Sha'ban was a total change in their behavior. I ask Allah Almighty to grant us the month of Ramadan. Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. I ask Allah Almighty to grant us the month of Ramadan and to be among the ones who prosper and are granted the peace from Allah Almighty and the forgiveness from Allah Almighty. And I ask Allah Almighty, and during the month of Sha'ban, that we perform at our best, where our 11 months are raised to Allah Almighty with good cause and intention. اللهم اغفر لنا خطأنا وجهلنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وما أنت أعلم به منا اللهم اغفر لنا ما قدمنا وما أخرنا وما أسررنا وما أعلنا أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر وأنت على كل شيء قدير اللهم أصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا واصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا واصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا واجعل الحياة زيادة في كل خير واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر اللهم نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكيها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم ألهمنا رشدنا وأعذنا من شرور أنفسنا اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وانصر الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم من أراد بهذا البلد وسائر بلاد المسلمين بخير فوفقه لما فيه خير ومن أراد بهذا البلد وسائر بلاد المسلمين شر فاجعل شره في نحره وتدميره في تدبيره يا أرحم الراحمين عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وأقم الصلاة